Hey guys, what's going on? I know I released a video earlier today about the June 28th data download for the JP side of Dokkan Battle and the global side, all the information up so far. But we just got another data download, and oh my gosh, there's so much awesome information available for us as of right now. Now, literally, we have so much to talk about. This is going to be a longer video. There's no official translation, so everything that I'm talking about right now is going to be used through Google Translate, so that's not your thing. Hopefully by tomorrow, the Reddit will have all the official translations, or the wiki, whatever one I end up using. I will end up doing a full guide like I always do for all this, but this just got downloaded within the past few hours, so I definitely want to make sure that I go and talk about it. So as of right now, as you see on the screen, I have the JP Dokkan, the OSTs are leaked. Now, I'm not going to play them in the video just because I don't think it's really warranted. We don't need to do that. If you want to go listen to the OSTs for the new battles, go head over to the Reddit. Check it out. I always do this. I actually have my my Reddit set up so that way it automatically comes up. Set it to Flare, official, and then sort by new, and you have all the newest information all over here within the past hour of data downloads. Now, we have all the JP data download information. We have all the super attacks. You can go check out my on Twitter. So it's my_FGC, downloaded directly from the game in-game information. Now, I'm not going to go over every single one of these. We're just going to talk about a couple of them. Once I go through some of the cards, like notably the Super Saiyan 4 Goku we have here. I actually have a different Reddit post that I'm going to use for the Super Saiyan 4. But we are getting an LR Korra, so I'm kind of hyped about that. We have the animations for both of them, and those are going to be the last that we play. This is LR Korra right over here. It's pretty freaking awesome. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, I still would like to have the Team Bardock, but since Bardock's already in LR, we're probably not gonna get that for a while. But he is going to be an extreme intelligence type, so again, we'll talk about all that. This is gonna be for the Super Saiyan 4 Super Attack. Goku, the Super Saiyan 4 Goku, also part of the new Full Power category, is now also part of the Shadow Dragon category. So Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta now has a linking buddy, so now you can run Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta, Super Saiyan 4 Goku, and Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta on your Omega Shenron team, which is awesome. So just keep that in mind. That's going to be pretty damn badass. Oh, and this Vegeta too, the TUR variant of that Vegeta, I know I've talked about him before. He's a very good unit, so is that Trunks. So honestly, your Shadow Dragons team is going to be pretty damn OP because you have that Super Saiyan 4 available. It might actually come back and make a comeback. Category Full Power, we now have all that information about who's going to be in it. Look at this. This is the Full Power Super Saiyan 4 category team. Oh my gosh, there's just so much to talk about here. I mean, let's start from the beginning. The Kaioken Gokus, the three Kaioken Gokus in-game right now look like they're going to be part of it. I would assume that also means they're TUR variants. You have the cells that are part of it, so you have the EZA cell. Super Saiyan 2 Gohan. LR Gohan is part of that. We'll also look at the card, too. But LR Gohan is going to be part of it. So I kind of understand what I was thinking about, what I said in one of my earlier videos, at least my assumption, was it was going to be the most powerful character part of the arc. So you have Buff Trunks, and Buff Trunks is one of the most powerful during the arc. You have all the Golden Freezes part of here, 100% Master Roshi. You have Bojack. Other Super Saiyan 2 Gohan, Super Saiyan 3 Gokus, Full Power Frieza, obviously, heck yeah. I wonder if Korra's in here, we're gonna have to find that out. Brolys are in here, it doesn't look like we have the LR Broly on 4. Oh no, we do have LR Broly right over here. So we have LR Broly part of this, so that's so awesome and so damn epic. Some of those Vegetas, Rage Goku, the Omega Shenrons are in here, Kaioken Blue Goku. It looks like we have other Kaioken Gokus, LR, but we already talked about LR Broly. Wow! Yo, they actually gave us the Super Saiyan Kaioken Goku part of that category. Khalifa is in here. The Angel Golden Freeze is here. Oh, look at that. Kefla is in here, along with Kaba and Kale. So that's pretty awesome, man. You have the False Super Saiyan Goku over here. I think they gave him the Kaioken, right? Yeah. The Super Saiyan Blue Evolution Vegeta and this other kid Goku looks like. I think this is a part of the newer one. So yeah, the Korra's not in here, which is weird, because you would kind of figure he's in here. I guess it would kind of like cover movie boss category type thing, but I mean, if they threw LR Bojack in there, Full Power Bojack, you kind of figure that they would throw Korra in there since he's the most powerful version of himself, even though he's only had the one movie. But I mean, that kind of stinks, because I would like the Frieza to have a linking buddy, but that's just for the villain side of it. This is a very nice team. I mean, there's no Gogeta, there's no fusions in here that I saw. So, but the LR Gohan's gonna be pretty good. I think he can link with some of the Super Saiyan 3s, so that wouldn't be too bad. Or the Kaioken Goku's, one of the Kaioken Super Saiyan, the Kaioken Blue Goku, that is. So that's awesome. We have the TUR variant of the Goku over here. Again, this is rough translations, but this is going to be pretty awesome. HP attack and defense plus 100% for the full power category. Then I would assume technique category is going to be key plus 3 HP attack and defense plus 90%. So I'm assuming that's going to be immense damage, greatly lowers defense. Own attack up plus 100% up. The more HP, the more attack and defense up plus 70%. So I'm assuming it's automatic attack plus 100% up. And then while you're getting closer to full power, you do more attack and defense. If that is the case, that might be a broken ability, because that could mean that you're going to automatically get the attack plus 100% up, and then all the links and all the like the passive skills of your other characters are going to come into play, and then you're going to get the additional 70% up. So that might be a little bit broken. Enemy death blow are invalidate with moderate probability, countering with ultra. So it looks like he's going to be have a medium chance to counter super attack. So that's pretty damn awesome. Super Saiyan Saiyan. Oh, yes. Okay. So we have Saiyan Roar, prepared for battle, shocking speed, Saiyan Blood GT, and Super Fierce Battle. Okay. That's pretty damn awesome, actually. That's really nice. I think what the only one that he would be missing at that point would probably be, Transform? Let's go over to the global side of it really quick. Too bad he doesn't have Saiyan Pride. That would be awesome. This is definitely not going to be 404. I've kind of figured that. I just want to go take a look at the Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta. Just to see how well he is going to net link with him, since there we go. Since the two of them are now probably going to be linking buddy. So Super Saiyan, Saiyan Roar. So Saiyan Pride is going to be the only one that he doesn't have with Vegeta. That kind of stinks. We really wish that they had the Saiyan Pride, but that's all right. That's not horrible. It's only a 15% buff that he doesn't have for him, and he's going to be broken. So that's going to be crazy. So I'm pretty happy about that. Wait a second. Did they have the Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta part of this category? Oh, no, they didn't have Super... How are you not going to have the Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta part of this damn category? Come on, Bandai. This is literally the most powerful version of it, of him in GT. Jeez. Anyway, that got me a little bit angry. But that's cool, though. Heck yeah. So at least they're going to have someone to link with. Okay, that's the 128. These are both 120 version. All right, cool. These are all the other cards that are also coming that are going to be available. Looks like we have Android 18, obviously the Super Saiyan 4 Goku, which you talked about, Android 17, Intelligence Frieza from GT, I think this is Angel, Cell. We have the Physical Frieza. I think one of these is probably going to be summonable. The others, maybe they are both going to be summonable. Maybe one of them is going to be from an event. I don't know yet. I don't know how you're going to attain any of this. Again, I'll talk about that when we get more information. So we have an Intelligence Frieza and a Physical Cell, and then we have a Physical Frieza and an Intelligence Cell. Those two are probably going to be, because since they're Dokkan Awakens, they're probably going to be Dokkan exclusives, part of the new banner that's coming around, and the other two might just be part of the banner as non-Dokkan Fest exclusives, but new unit. Looks like we're also getting Kid Goku from GT, and yes, the LR Korra. So we do have so much. I don't know anything about the Frieza or the Cell, so we're just going to look at the TURs of the new units that are coming out. We're going to kind of forego the other ones right now. Just trying to keep everything shorter in the video. So the TUR final form Frieza, let's see over here. Let's go ahead and translate this over to English just to see what's going on with it. The attitude of polar attributes. So it looks like HP attack and defense plus 90% for physical type. Man, I can't even read this right now. It looks like attack and defense plus 80 evil deepened in hell. Own attack and defense plus 80% up. And if attacking partner is a deadly motion sealed state, add an additional 100% attack with outstanding effect on all attributes. So that's interesting. So I don't know what that means. I would assume that this means when your opponent is sealed from super attacks, you do an additional 100%. That would be an interesting mechanic in-game. The thing that stinks about that is it doesn't take effect on most Dokkan events. So again, we'll have to wait and see what happens with that. Let's see. So he has Genius, or I guess that would be Brainiacs, right? Shocking Speed, Strongest Clan in Space. Nightmare, I don't know what these are, Shattering the Limit. So he gets Shattering the Limit, so that's... Alright, that's not that bad. I think he's a pretty cool unit. Let's take a look and see what he actually looks like. Okay, that's pretty nice artwork, I like that. Again, I'm a big fan of Frieza. Like in Dragon Ball Legends, I literally summoned, I think about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6. I think I probably used over 6,000 Chrono... No, actually, I've used about 10,000 Chrono Crystals just trying to pull Frieza. And he's not even that viable in-game, I just really like Frieza. This is going to be the Cell. Let's take a look at that artwork real quick. Beautiful artwork. I like that. Look, he just looks so maniacal, so angry at everything. Let's go ahead and translate this real quick. So, it's going to be Intelligence, HP attack and defense plus 90%. Super extensive damage. It's probably going to be immense damage. Actually, great. We can't even see what he's going to do. over here. Maybe we could refresh the page and get it back to Japanese, and we'll just take a look. So it looks like attack and defense plus 80% up. I don't know what it's going to constitute his attack plus 100% up, but I guess it's going to be something similar to Frieza. It looks like he has 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Damn, he has 10 healings. Holy crap, he's freaking ridiculous. There's probably going to be Revival in there. I would assume it's going to be Revival. GT, Shattering the Limit. And he's going to have two other ones. I don't know what the heck these are. Let's see if we can understand what the heck that is. Connoisseur wouldn't be there. You know what? We can go over here and take a look at that. See which ones he has. Translate to English, plus 2. Short-term battle, that's E plus 3, wouldn't it? Aerobic, shocking speed. So he probably has shocking speed up in here. Yeah, all right, interesting. But yeah, he has a whole bunch of link skills. That's going to be awesome. I can't wait. Actually, here we go. Pull full power hands. Let's see over here. Do we have... Oh, this is probably just linking back to the... Yeah, it's just linking back over here. So that's awesome. All right, cool. So these are all the newer units. Which other one did I want to see? Oh, the LR Korra, which I want to take a look at all his information as well. Guys, I'm doing this on the whim. I have not checked out any of this information yet. I don't know how LR Korra is going to come into play, because he's doing key plus 3, HP attack and defense plus 70%. To me, that makes me believe he's going to be a free-to-play character. I have no idea if he is or not. So I would just assume that, because who gets HP attack and defense plus 70% for a specific type? You know what I'm saying? That's very, very old school. Superlative maximum damage. I'm assuming it's going to be catastrophic to your opponent. One turn, pulls, attack plus 30%. So raises attack plus 30%. Huge group of nightmare. The more HP there are, attack and defense up to 90%. And up to 2 times with a high probability of attacking. So you get attacked twice. They have a high probability of attacking twice. And sometimes with a low chance or a medium chance of being a super attack. So he has the HP recovery, shock, speed, nightmare, strongest clan in space, big bad bosses, fear and faith, or fear and despair, however you want to look at that, and legendary power. So it's not that horrible. It looks like this definitely looks like the stats of a free-to-play LR. 100% my opinion on the matter, obviously. I don't know. I have no idea. The one thing I did want to look at, let's see. Let's take a look at his super attack real quick. We'll go over here. Alright, that didn't really look too impressive. Actually, it looks like it was actually part of the banner, so that's actually really interesting. So, I wonder, maybe he's going to be a featured LR. He definitely doesn't look that great. It looks like he might just be part of the LR banner, one of the new LRs. Who knows? We'll have to see. Let's take a look at the Super Saiyan 4, the 100% Super Saiyan 4 Goku super attack real quick. Okay, standard Kamehameha. Oh, and he comes in for a launch. That's a pretty damn epic, scary looking thing. Oh, with the super Kamehameha with a super dragon fist? What? Holy crap! And that's his 100, like level 100 super attack. Oh my gosh, that's so crazy. Oh man, I don't know if I want to go through all these right now. Let's go over here, because I think the Reddit actually had both. So let me go over here. That was like the level 100. I'm assuming the next one's going to be the TUR. Oh, I guess not. Oh, here we go. Alright. Well, it's alright. So we have all that information, so that's pretty... I guess that was also the background of the new OST, I would assume. So that's pretty freaking cool. I'm not going to lie, I like it. I definitely like the animation there. Let's see. I guess this is the TUR Strength GT Goku. We don't need to full screen that. Let's take a look at this and see what happened. Oh, Android 18 is part of it. All right, cool. So it looks like Android 18 is providing some cover fire. Actually, that's pretty damn cool. I like that. All right. Heck yeah. And then he does a little miniature Super Dragon Fist. All right, that's cool. Hell yeah. Let's take a look at Frieza's, because I do like Frieza. Don't get me wrong. I think I did see part of Frieza's actually a little bit earlier. So that one's not too... Oh, no, I didn't. That's definitely not the one. That's the intelligence one. Oh, look, and then it's the Frieza Destructo Disc. That's pretty awesome. Here's Cell, physical Cell. Wow, Frieza's Death Beam, huh? And then Special Beam Cannon? What? Holy crap! That is so awesome. That is so awesome. Hell yeah. I love it. Oh, this is the other Frieza's, I guess, super attack over here. There's level 100 super attack. Oh, no, this is the other. I think the other one was the intelligence Frieza. This is the physical Frieza. Okay, yes, this is the one that I saw. Hell yeah. So epic. It's so freaking epic. I love it. I think Cell would probably be the same as the Frieza. It is. Yeah, it's the same one. It doesn't matter. Let's go take a look over here at the Android 18. There she goes. It's pretty funny, I'm not going to lie. I love how she's in her, like, just in, like, business casual clothes. All right. Standard super attack. Android 17. Let's take a look at him real quick. I know I didn't want to turn this into a longer video, but I definitely am doing that right now. All right. Nothing crazy. He just launches an energy ball. All right. Cool. All right, that's not bad. Yeah, that's it for all the super attacks. All right, cool. That's not bad. Those are all of the super attacks as we saw them. I'm still super hyped about this category. I can't wait to, like, check that out. I can't wait for it to come to global, obvious. It's probably, we got another, like, 6 months on global, so we have some time before that becomes a thing. But yeah, guys, that's all the new units that are available. We have so much going on. Oh, man, I'm super hyped about this. This kind of distracted me a little bit because I needed to record some videos for the weekend, so you might go a day without a video. I still have to do my summons for Global Dragon Ball Saga banner that's currently available for the, from the World Tournament, because I want that damn Jackie Chun. But anyway, guys, I'm super hyped about this. Let me know what you guys think about it down in the comments below, and I'll catch y'all later. Yeah, have a good one.